General refrigeration plant of a dairy industry. So here we are at experimental dairy. These are compressor of refrigeration system installed here. So this is a double cylinder reciprocating compressor used for compression of ammonia, which is used as a refrigerant here. This is the crankcase of this compressor, which is mounted by this flywheel or a larger pulley in which a power transmission system with 4 V beds in parallel. These two pulleys coupled together by using 4 V beds here, and this is an induction motor. So it is the main prime mover of the system. So it will be supplied with electrical energy, and that electrical energy will be transferred via this power transmission system to this main flywheel of the compressor, which is connected on the central shaft where the crank and shaft arrangement is mounted. So here we are seeing there are two separate cylinders in which pistons are working. So as this is a reciprocating compressor and we are having two cylinders, so when one cylinder is in suction stroke, then another cylinder will be in discharge stroke. So this is the head of this compressor. In this head of compressor, during its working, it becomes very hot. So for that head cooling, we are having a water jacket arrangement. These pipelines, so these green colored pipelines connected to this head. This pipeline, which is connected at the bottom side of this jacket, is for inlet of cooling water coming from the cooling tower, and this top water pipeline is for outgoing cooling water going back to the cooling tower. Now coming on to the refrigerant side, this side we are having an insulated line. So this is carrying vapor ammonia from the evaporator of the system. The direction has been marked on the wall. So we can also identify on this basis that this is the suction line of the system, and this another line, this is the discharge line of the system. So both the suction and discharge line are connected with these valves. So these valves will be used for isolation of the compressor if required from the system. This is the incoming line. To identify it, we are having an insulated line, and for discharge line, uninsulated line. As the suction line is coming from the evaporator, it will be having low temperature vapor ammonia coming from the evaporator, and at the discharge end after compressor, we will be having compressed high temperature, high pressure vapor ammonia coming out of the compressor and going to the condenser. So in the condenser, this vapor ammonia is required to be condensed. So for condensation of ammonia, we are leaving this pipeline uninsulated so that due to the temperature difference of the vapors and the environment, some of the cooling effect will be before reaching the cooling tower. So it will be helping the system overall to improve the overall efficiency of the system. Now coming on to control of this compressor, we are having three gauges. So this is oil pressure gauge, which is the lubricating oil present in the crankcase. This is suction pressure of the ammonia coming from the evaporator, and this is the discharge pressure gauge. These lines are coming at this side. So this line is for discharge pressure going to the discharge gauge. This line is for suction pressure going to the suction gauge, and this another line, which we can see, it is connected at this side. So this is for oil pressure here at this side. This is for oil pressure. Now coming on to the other supplies, this particular pipeline, this is for emptying of the water jacket when required for cleaning the water jacket side. And this side we are having oil pump. So this oil pump will be supplying the oil at a constant pressure to the system. When crank with the piston will be moving, it will be requiring lubrication, and that lubrication will be provided by supplying the oil from the oil pump onto the piston from below. So that when piston is going to and fro motion, then that oil is forming a thin film, and that thin film will be reducing the friction between the component. Now coming on to the connections, this suction line is connected to that insulated pipeline at this side, and this discharge line is connected to that red colored line near to this wall. So these two lines are for suction and discharge. So suction line is coming from the evaporators, all the evaporators whatever are there in this plant, and discharge line is going to the condenser.